Hi friends, we will continue the problems on the Dyson Aspa case. So I want to consider a problem. A compressor running at 400 rpm is driven by a 25 kilowatt 1200 rpm motor through a pair of 14.5 involute spark gates. The center distance is around 400 mm. The pinion is made up of 4 steel of static allowable stresses 190 MN per meter square and 350 bhn. The gear is to be made of cast steel of static allowable stresses 180 MN per meter square and 300 bhn. Design the gear for a safe continuous operation. Check the gear for endurance, wear, dynamic strength and name the class of the gear. So what are the data is given? The power is given, that is 25 kilowatt rpm, that is motor rpm, that is 1200 rpm. N2, the compressor rpm, is 400 rpm. Alpha they specified 14.5. Center distance between the shaft is 400, from which I can calculate the D value. Sigma naught 1 allowable stress, they are given in MN per meter square, converted into Newton per mm square for both pin and as gear. And they are given the surface hardness. So this is the first problem where they are given a surface hardness also. So pinion they are given as 350 bhn, the gear they are given as 300 bhn. So velocity ratio I is equals to N1 by N2, both the values are given. So I want to get I velocity ratio as 3. So D2 by D1 is equals to I, so D2 will be equals to I into D1. Since the center distance is given, A is equals to D1 plus D2 by 2. So I want to substitute D2 as I into D1. So I want to get D1 plus ID1 by 2. So D1 is equals to 1 plus 3 by 2. That is, I want to get as D1 as 200 mm. So D2 will be equals to I into D1, that is 3 into 200, 600 mm. Since the diameter is known, I have to assume the Z value for calculating only the weaker member. So temporarily I want to assume the teeth on the pinion as Z1 equals to 20. So I want to get Z2 I into Z1, that is 3 into 20 as 60. Since the given as 14.5 involute profile, for a 14.5 involute profile, Lewis factor will be equals to Y is equals to 0.124 minus 0.684 by Z. So I want to calculate for both pinion as well as the gear. So pinion I want to get 0.0898. For a gear I want to get as 0.1126. So to identify the weaker member, I want to substitute the form values, that is pinion, allowable stress, Lewis form factor, I want to get a product as 17.064. Similarly for a gear, allowable stress as 180, Y value as 0.1126. So I want to get as product as 20.268. From this table it is clear that pinion will be the weaker member, so the design should be based on the pinion. So going for the design step, so first I want to calculate the tangential tooth load. So FT is equals to 9550 into 1000 into N into CS divided by N1 R1. Previously you are selecting the service factor from the table 23.13, so but here you have to go for a different table. So I have to go for a table of 14.7 because they clearly specify it is a compressor of a continuous valve. So I can go for a 14.7 table. From there I can get CS is equal to 1.75. So since dia is known, I want to write R1 is equal to D1 by 2, that is 200 by 2, it will be 100 mm. By substituting this value, so I am going to get FT is equal to 3481.8 Newton. The second step in the design will be tangential tooth load from the Lewis equation. I am going to get FT is equal to sigma naught B YP into KV. Since Y I calculated by assuming the Z value, here I want to substitute the Z in terms of D by M. So I want to substitute D by M. So D1 by M. So D1 is 100. So I want to get Y2 is equals to 0.124 minus 6.84 into 10 to the power of minus 3 M. So B I want to assume as 10 M. And Y is P is given by pi into M. So KV, that is the velocity factor I have to calculate. So VM I going to calculate pi D1 N1 divided by 60,000. So I want to get pi into 200 into 1200 divided by 60,000. I want to get at 12.566 meter per second, which is greater than 12.5 and less than 20. So I want to select the equation 23.136A. So velocity factor is given by 6 by 6 plus VM. So VM formula I want to substitute over here. I want to get as 0.3231. Substituting this in the above equation, I want to get FT is equals to this much. So by equating this FT value, equation 1 and equation 2, so I want to get m square minus 0.02758 m cube, that will be equals to 14.555. So that is m square minus 0.02758 m cube should be greater than 14.555. So I want to assume the m value. So first I want to assume as 4 mm from the table 23.3. So m square minus 2758 m cube, that is m I going to substitute as 4, I going to get as 14.235, which is less than 14.355. So it is not suitable. So trial 2, I going to assume m is equal to 5. So I going to substitute the 5 value over here, that is I going to get as 21.5525, which is greater than 14.555. So hence it is suitable. So I going to select module as 5 mm. So check for the stresses whether the selected model is safe or not. So sigma allowable is equal to sigma naught 1 into kV, so 190 into 0.3232, so 61.40 newton per mm square I want to get. So again sigma induced, I want to substitute ft by b y1 into p. So y1 formula I want to substitute, that is the 0.124 minus 3.420 into the power of minus 3 into m. So m I want to replace with 5, b I want to replace with 10 into 5, and p I want to replace with pi into 5. So I'm going to get sigma induced as 41.47 newton per mm square. From this, it is clear that sigma allowable is greater than sigma induced. That is for, so the design is safe and a module selected is also safe. That is module m is equals to 5 mm. So next step will be design dimensions. So module is known. So I want to calculate z1 and z2. So that is d1 by m, d2 by m. I'm going to get as 40 teeth and 120 teeth. So p pi into m, so I'm going to get as 15.708 mm. So from the table 23.1 all for alpha 14.5 degree. So what are the formulas I'm going to get? That is addendum, dedendum, working depth, old depth, thickness, everything I want to calculate. So if I take this HA, it will be 1 mm. That is dedendum will be 1.157 mm. Working depth will be 2 mm. Old depth will be 2.15 mm. And thickness will be pi by 2 into m. So coming into checking, so previous problem we are checking only the dynamic and the wear load. So in this case they asked the endurance also, so you have to check for three loads: dynamic, endurance as well as the wear. So let us go for the first one, the dynamic load. So equation number 23.155, so fd is equals to ft plus 21 vm multiplied by ft plus bc divided by 21 vm plus root of ft plus bc. So in this case you have to calculate c value. So since vm is known and the class of gear is not given, I'm going to consider VM and the figure number 23.35A. So I want for a VM value 12.5664. Error I'm going to select as 0.03. So again I'll go for the table 23.32. For a 14.5 steel combination, I'm going to get 0.025 as 279.48. 0.03 is the unknown, I have to calculate. 0.05 as 5558.8. So I want to go for the equation X minus this value divided by this minus this value. Similarly, that will be equal to 0.03 minus 0.05 and 0.05 minus 0.025. So I want to get the value as x is equals to 335.344 newton per mm. C, that is the load factor or C value. So therefore, FD is equals to 3481.8 and the remaining I want to substitute over there. So FD I want to get as 16637.1 newton. So now endurance, it is the first problem where you are dealing with the endurance. So endurance strength FF is given by sigma SF BY into M. Sigma SF is the endurance limit which can be taken from the table number 23.33, and capital Y is nothing but pi into Y1, that is pi into the Lewis form factor, and M will be the module and B will be the face weight. So from the table 23.33, since the hardness is given, that is commonly I want to take as 350 bhn, so endurance limit sigma SF will be equal to 620.5 newton per mm square. You can see in the table. So I am substituting that sigma SF value, B value. So pi into Y, so Y value I want to take from the previous equation. So Y into pi I want to get as 0.336. Substituting that and modulus 5 I want to get as 52122 newton. So from the previous, that is FW, that is 16637.1. And from this, that is FF is greater than FD. So I can say that design is satisfactory. The endurance limit is greater than the dynamic load. So coming on to wear load, so FW, that will be equal to D1 BQK. So previous and all you are taking the K as the unknown, then you are calculating the k value. But here you have to calculate the k and you have to find the fw value, because they are given already the surface hardness. So q are going to take 2z2 by z1 plus z2, so that will be equal to 1.5. So to find the k value, first I am going to go for the formula. K is equal to 1.43 sigma fact square. The sigma fact is nothing but the limiting stress for a fatigue surface fatigue. So sine alpha divided by E naught. E naught is nothing but the equivalent Young's modulus. So equivalent Young's modulus is given by 2E1E2 divided by E1 plus E2. So this values I can get from the table 2.10 in the volume 1. So for each material I can get. So Young's modulus for a steel is 206 into 10 to the 206 GPa. So are I going to write that one as 206 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per mm square. So I want to get E naught. That is E naught value I want to find out. That is 206 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per mm square. So now sigma fact, that is the limiting stress for a surface fatigue, I have to calculate from the equation 23.168. That is given by 2.7 HB minus 669 into MPa. So HB value, so it is nothing but hardness number. So for the hardness number, you have to calculate both the average, that is hardness number of the pinion, hardness number of the gear, divided by 2. I want to get as 325 BHN. So I want to substitute HB value over here. So I want to get the value as sigma phi is equals to 824.75 Newton per mm square. So K value, I want to substituting this, I want to get K value as 1.18226. So therefore, Fw is equal to D1BQK, all the values will be substituted over here. So I'm going to get Fw is equal to 17733.9 Newtons. So from this, you can clearly say that Fw is greater than Fd, the design will be safer. And they asked to calculate the class of the gear also. So to get the class of the gear, you have to go for the figure number 23.34, which you used to calculate the service factor. For a model 5 and factor of, error 0.03 mm, the class of the gear is a commercial gear, that is class 3. So that finishes the problem.